Today, let's discuss one of the important topics in mathematics of class 10th, trigonometry. So, the meaning of trigonometry, tri means 3, gono means sides, and metry means measurements. That is, it is nothing but three-sided figure measurements. What is three-sided figure? It's nothing but triangle. So, every triangle will have three sides and three angles, total 6 elements. I have drawn one triangle ABC consisting of angle A, angle B, angle C. Normally, the angles are represented in capital letters and the sides opposite to angle A is represented by small letter A, opposite to angle B by small b, and opposite to angle C by small c. Every triangle has got three sides, therefore, we can write 6 ratios. First, let us write these ratios with reference to a right angle triangle, and later on it can be extended to any triangle. So here I have drawn ABC, a right angle triangle. So you must know the names. The side which is opposite to angle 90 is called hypotenuse. Now in the figure which I have shown in this, AB is perpendicular for C, or AB is opposite to C, or AB is adjacent to A. Adjacent means by the side of. So now here angle A is here, therefore AB is the adjacent side for A. For angle C, BC is the adjacent side. Similarly, for angle A, BC is perpendicular. For angle C, AB is perpendicular. In some textbooks, you will observe that the adjacent side is represented as base side and the opposite side is represented as perpendicular. So, hereafter, we follow perpendicular by the letter P, base by the letter B, and hypotenuse by the letter H. So as I said that there are three sides, so 6 ratios are possible. So here if I say with reference to A, I can write perpendicular by hypotenuse, base by hypotenuse, and perpendicular by base. So these are the basic ratios in trigonometry. The ratio of perpendicular to the hypotenuse is written as sine A. In short, we write SINA. And the name given to the base by hypotenuse is cosine A, or simply COSA, cos A. The name given to perpendicular by base is tangent A, or simply tan A. We write tan A in short. So now, what is sin A from the figure? In the figure, what is perpendicular for A? For A, BC is the perpendicular. Therefore, BC by AC is the formula for sin A. Suppose somebody wants to write the formula for sin C. Sin C is again perpendicular by hypotenuse. But what is perpendicular for sin C? AB by AC. So for any angle, first of all, you must identify what is perpendicular for it, what is hypotenuse for it, and what is base for it. Once you identify those things, it is very easy for us to write the ratios sin A, cos A, and tan A. Now, the reciprocal. So, when we have written perpendicular by hypotenuse, we can also write a ratio hypotenuse by perpendicular. That is named as cosecant A or simply cosec A. The reciprocal of cos hypotenuse by base is secant A or simply sec A. Then the reciprocal of tan base by perpendicular is named as cotangent or simply cot A. Once you are familiar with these six ratios, you can easily do any problem of trigonometry. Of course, in some parts of India, they use a mnemonics to memorize or to remember these ratios. It looks like this: Pandit Badri Prasad Har Har Bole. Here, P by H, this is the formula for sine. Base by hypotenuse is the formula for cosine. And perpendicular by base is the formula for tan. And the reciprocals, sine reciprocal is cosec, cos reciprocal is sec, and tan reciprocal is cotangent. Of course, by doing many problems, you will be able to write the formula very easily. So, first let us do some problems based on this formula. So, this is the very first problem given in your textbook. So, you must draw the figures properly. So, in triangle ABC, right angle at B, you should write, this is A, B and C, this is 90 degrees. It's given in the figure. Now, this AC is hypotenuse. Now, AB is given as 24 centimeter and BC as 7 centimeter. Of course, I have not scaled it. Let's actually 7 means somewhere here you have to draw. Anyway, this schematic diagram only. Now, here you have to find out AC. So, for that you must know the Pythagoras theorem tells us the hypotenuse square is always equal to sum of the squares of remaining two sides. So, AB square plus BC square. So, here AB square is 24 square, BC square is 7 square. So, 576 plus 49, which is 625. Therefore, AC is equal to 25 centimeters. Okay, so the very first thing that you have to find out the unknown side. Now, once you know this, then you can write the ratios very easily. Sine A is asked. We know the formula for sine perpendicular by hypotenuse. Cos A, we know the formula base by hypotenuse. Sine C, for C perpendicular by hypotenuse, for C, cos C is base by hypotenuse again, but for C the base is BC, for A the base is AB. So here now for A, I can write perpendicular is 7 and hypotenuse is 25. As the ratio of centimeter to centimeter, so trigonometric ratios will not have any units. So here cos A, for A the base is 24 and hypotenuse is 25. Sine C, this is C, for this perpendicular is 24, hypotenuse is 25. Cos C, base by hypotenuse, base is 7 and hypotenuse is 25. So, this is the First, problem solution. It's very easy if you remember the Pythagoras theorem. So first of all, you have to find out the unknown term, and second, we have to remember the formulae. Perpendicular by hypotenuse is sin A, base by hypotenuse is cos A with reference to A. Okay, now this is your second problem. So in this second problem, first of all, this QR is to be calculated. So again, we write, so PQ square plus QR square is equal to PR square. Therefore, QR square is equal to PR square minus PQ square. Now, QR is equal to square root of PR square, that is 13 square, and PQ square, that is 12 square. So you can write it as 13 plus 12 into 13 minus 12. So which gives you 25. Therefore, it is 5 centimeters. Now, in the problem, it is asked tan P. The formula for tan is perpendicular by base. For P, this is angle P, for which it is the perpendicular 5, and base is 12. So, 5 by 12. Next, cot R. Cot is nothing but base by perpendicular, because it is reciprocal of tan. So, for R, the base is 5 and perpendicular is 12. So, as the two ratios are same, tan P minus cot R is equal to 5 by 12 minus 5 by 12, which is 0. So, this is also calculating the unknown side of the given figure and then applying the formulae. Now, this one. So, here sin A is given. So, let us draw a figure and name this as A. Then, this, if you write this as A, B 90 degrees, and then C. It is given that sin A is equal to 3 by 4. Sin A. What is the formula? Perpendicular by hypotenuse. What is perpendicular for A? BC. Hypotenuse is AC. This ratio is 3 by 4. Or we can say, let it be 3x and then this hypotenuse be 4x. Now, this side we have to calculate. Then, this will be 4x whole square minus 3x whole square, because hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square will give us base square according to Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, this is going to be root 7 times of x, because 4 plus 3 and 4 minus 3 is 1. So, once you know this side, now we can write easily cos A. What is cos A? Base by hypotenuse. What is base here? Root 7x by hypotenuse is 4x. Therefore, root 7 by 4. Now, what is tangent A? Perpendicular by base. What is perpendicular here? 3x. What is base? Root 7x. So, this x will be cancelled. And 3 by root 7 is the answer for us for tan A. Next, fourth. In the fourth problem, 15 cot A is equal to 8. Again, we draw the triangle. A, B, C. Given that 15 cot A is equal to 8, therefore cot A is equal to 8 by 15, or we can say 8x by 15x. So what is cot actually? Cot is perpendicular by base is tan, so base by perpendicular is cot. So for A, the base is 8x, that is AB, and then perpendicular, this is 15x, of course not to scale. Then this would be 15x whole square plus 8x whole square. So 15x whole square means how much it is? AC is equal to 225x square, and this is 64x square, which is 289x square. Therefore, it will be simply 17x. Now, once you know the three sides, you can easily tackle what is sine A. Sine A is, the formula is perpendicular by hypotenuse. For A, the perpendicular is BC and hypotenuse is AC. Therefore, 15x by 17x, which gives you 15 by 17. Similarly, secant A is nothing but hypotenuse by base. For A, hypotenuse is AC, base is AB. Therefore, it is 15x by 8x. So, 15 by 8 is the final ratio for secant A.